Just a few days ago, a military base in the state of Alabama became one of the first places to actually insist on vaccine passports. And what that means is that if you can prove that you've been vaccinated on this military base, you don't have to wear a mask. If you can't do it or if you're not vaccinated, you have to wear a face covering. Simple as that, right? Well, apparently this pissed off Republican Representative Mo Brooks from the state of Alabama to the point where he wrote a letter to President Biden and warned him that you've got to reverse the mask mandate because, my God, these masks might be causing cancer. Here's what Brooks wrote in his little letter. I suspect time will reveal that masks, while arguably promoting health, also endanger the health of those who wear them. Masks have small fibers that regularly loosen and are lodged in users' lungs. Some masks have inks and dyes which, when consumed by lungs, have unknown cancer and other health risks. Certainly, all or almost all masks reduce oxygen intake into the human body. With all the risk this imposes, there is also the unknown risk that in the heat and humidity of summers in the South, heat stroke risks increase among mask wearers. So suddenly you're concerned about the public's health, right, Mo? Like, oh my God, people can't protect themselves from a deadly virus because they could end up with health problems. Do you see the irony in that, Mo? At all, just maybe a little bit of irony, you could see it, but no. Also, why is there not massive cancer rates, I guess lung cancer rates, among healthcare professionals, doctors, nurses, hospice workers, any of these folks, you know, people who wear masks literally every day as part of their job at one point or another? Why do we not see massive lung cancer rates among these individuals? Because as you say, you know, the little fibers might get down into your lungs. Here's a problem though. They're not carcinogens. So yeah, I mean, I suppose if you're wearing a mask made of asbestos, then yeah, there's probably gonna be a pretty severe cancer risk there. But these little fibers you're talking about, it's really no different than what you might inhale in a dusty room or while putting on a shirt, Mo. There's fibers, there's little cotton fibers everywhere. What do you think dust is made of, man? Skin cells? Cotton fibers? You know, little pieces of things that deteriorate over time? We're breathing all this stuff in constantly and not getting lung cancer from it. If you were truly concerned about public health, you wouldn't be writing this letter saying that you don't want these individuals to protect themselves. And as for the heat of the summer, totally get ya. I'm down here in an area that's not only hotter than Alabama, but it's far more humid than Alabama. So you know what I have done in the summer, and I did last summer too? Got rid of the cotton mask, put on one of those, you know, blue masks, and hey, suddenly your face doesn't get so hot. It's really not that difficult, Mo. But you're trying to drum up a controversy where none exists. You're trying to pander to a base that you don't care if they live or die, but you still think somehow it's going to help you politically. Well, encouraging these people to not wear masks, trying to fight for their right to not wear masks, that's just going to result in more people being killed. And I, you know, guess I'm a little slow to see how that's going to help you electorally when the people who support you the most are 6 feet underground. Hey, thanks for watching. And if you want even more Ring of Fire, we encourage everyone to like, comment, share, but most importantly, subscribe. And don't forget, you can find me on all social media outlets at Farron Balanced.